Hey everybody, Trinity here. Welcome back. It's been quite a while since we last were together with this game. Several weeks, maybe a couple of months. It was right after the game first came out that I made the first video of my Let's Play because I was excited. I wanted to dive right in, and I had gone through the vault before so I knew what to expect. So I went ahead and did that video and uploaded it for you guys. But after that, I took a break. I wanted to play through the game at least once, learn a few things, find some items, figure out where I wanted to go with the game before I dove right in with the rest of the videos. I've finally done that now. I feel better about the game, know how to play it, so you don't have to spend a lot of time with me screwing things up. And we're ready to rock and roll now, finally. I'll be putting these out much more regularly now for the rest of the way. Much like I'm going to do with my Skyrim videos, I'm going to try to do each video a standalone quest kind of thing. And in this video, we're just going to go down to Sanctuary Hills there and see what has happened down there in the past 200 years. We had just gotten out of the vault. You see, there's our hometown all smashed to pieces. We're going to go see what's going on down there. A couple things before I get started. You'll notice the game looks a little different than the vanilla experience and even my first video. I've got texture packs installed here for the graphical things. Got some HD texture packs. Things are going to look a little different in my game than they may in yours. So that's one thing. The other thing is I have an ENB installed. As you can tell with the lighting in my game and shadows is pretty different than the default experience. But I thought it was pretty cool. So I'm going to go with this for a while. So that's why my game looks different. I have a few other smaller mods installed, but nothing too dramatic. And as they appear along the way, I'll explain to you what they are. But for the most part, it's mostly a vanilla experience. Okay, well, let's go down here to Sanctuary Hills and see what's been up while we've been gone. Say goodbye to Vault 111. Very cool looking. This is much less green than it was the first time we came through. Check my journal and see what we got. Out of time. The objective is to go home. So let's go home. Here's Sanctuary. Definitely has seen better days. Hey, look, there's a familiar face.
As I live and breathe!
Codsworth!
Oh, it's really you!
Now, you see here, one mod I have here changes the dialogue. As you see here, the dialogue choices, now it shows exactly what your guy's gonna say, so you don't have to try to guess what he's gonna say. Which kind of matches up more like the original Fallout games. A lot of times I was making mistakes trying to guess what my character was trying to say, and I would get negative. Thanks. And I'd get negative feedback from the character I was talking to, so this mod makes that much, much easier.
Codsworth? You're still here. So, other people could still be alive too.
But of course I'm still here! Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the wife see you in that state, hmm? Where is the missus, by the way?
Oh, well, she's in a better place.
She's in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction.
Distraction.
A distraction to calm this dire mood.
Okay.
It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Charades? Yep, he's been kidnapped.
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Thanks, Codsworth. I feel fine.
Doesn't matter how long it's been. I feel fine.
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little. For the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're two centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
You okay?
Codsworth. You're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Oh, son, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Pull yourself together, man. Just stay with me.
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, everything happened.
All right, thanks.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Well. Shall we search the neighborhood together?
Okay.
Mrs. and young Shaw may turn up yet.
Okay, well, he straightened up pretty quick. All right, let's do it.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir.
Time to sweep the neighborhood.
Terrific! It's a fight then.
What we have in here?
Picking up hostile
control. Oh! Float flies. Cha-ching!
Apparently decided we were too much trouble.
Did he open that refrigerator?
Flies. Wait. My senses are picking up movement in another house.
Okay.
Follow me.
Lead the way. I like Codsworth. He's a pretty cool character.
What's all this, then? Not this time.
If I want to kill these things, I gotta get in there before him because he hogs all the action. Oh. There they are. Oh, come on. How you missed that? There you go. Oh, there's another one coming. Ah, crap. Spit on me or whatever the hell that is. 2. And Codsworth steals my glory.
Don't worry. I, Mr. Trinity, your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
I told you they were gone. It's all right.
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
You can't give up, sir. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
That's a plus. All right. Thanks.
Thanks for your help, Codsworth.
Good luck, sir. You'll find young Sean. I know you will. I shall remain here and secure the home.
Yes, I will. It's always weird in this game. They pronounce Concord as Concord, and I don't know. Maybe that's the proper way to pronounce it as Concord, but I would always call it Concord, so it's always weird when I hear it pronounced Concord, as in someone's been defeated and conquered. But oh well, I guess those words are pronounced differently depending on where you live. All right, well first, before we go to Concord, we're gonna take a look around this town here and maybe loot a few things. Eventually, not long from now, this becomes one of your very first settlements where you can build things and have settlers and all that good stuff. That's on down the line a little bit, but there are a couple of items worth grabbing in here if I could find them. I don't remember where they're at though, so bear with me while I explore some of these dumpy houses. Let's see what we have in here. I think there's a few enemies too. Bloat flies mostly. Take that glue. Early on in this game, keep every stitch of glue you can get your hands on, because that stuff's like gold. Early on, anyway. Later it's not as rare. And plus, you can do some things to create glue, but early on, it's really valuable. right? Not much in there. Just gonna check each one of these houses as I head back to the main house. I might miss a few things, but it's not really that big a deal. Just kind of want to scan over it. All right, I know how to lockpick. Maybe I do. Ah, don't break it. Some bobby pin I got. Ah. Come on. Yes. Sweet. Sweet. I'll take that, that, this, that. I don't want the pipe pistol. My gun's better. I'll take the stim pack. Thank you. Let's save. It's a Fallout game, so you know the drill. Save often. Save often. What is all this stuff? Okay, heading out of here. What direction was it coming from? That one. That house is trashed. Check this house. Hello? Anyone home? What's this? Bread box. I don't want the bread box. There's Mr. Handy. There's Codbert's box. I'm guessing that's who that belongs to. Yeah, because this looks like this is my old house. My house sucks. There's nothing here. I hear Codsworth flying around. This is the main house. Now we can use this as a workshop and we can scrap some things and build some things. I'm not going to do that right now, but I got it set up and ready to go for next time. Oh, there's a bobby pin. Definitely want that. Okay, almost done. Hello? So which way did that come from? I keep getting turned around. Uh-oh. I knew there were some enemies in some of these places. Ah! Jeez. Nice. Looks like I earned a critical, but I don't want to waste it on a stupid roach. I might move around and do a few things here in town. Ah, damn. And do a few things in town so I can level up before I try to go to Concord. It shouldn't take too terribly long for me to level up.
Nice.
Yeah, all that for a formal hat, and I'll leave it there. The lockpicking in this game, honestly, is way easier than it was in the other Fallout games, or even Skyrim. To me, it seems a lot easier. I'm not sure why, but the lockpicks, the bobby pins themselves seem a lot more sturdy, so they don't seem to break quite as easy. More bugs around here. Alright, let's try to unlock this. I'm gonna do this just like I did my Fallout 3 Let's Play when it comes to hacking terminals. If I fail, I'm not gonna load a save and keep going until I get it. That's the easy way out. And I do that sometimes when I play the game, but in this one I'm going to try to keep it as legit as possible and try to pass these stupid things. So if I screw up and fail, then that's just going to be it. So I'm going to try to be careful here. Nope. Mean has two letters. Kane has three.
There we go.
Got it. But this is just I'm not going to read all this stuff. But it looks like this guy's some kind of like drug dealer in town here, and he's got notes on various people here. But I'm not gonna read all that stuff. I just wanted to hack the terminal to get the experience. Game's looking really good. Ooh, makeshift bomb. we will disarm that. Okay. Gotta be careful. I only have one bobby pin. Yes!
Got it.
Okay. Pre-war money. Pre-war money, you can scrap it. I think it produces cloth, something like that. But the main thing I use pre-war money for is to sell it. You collect that and go and sell it and make a pretty penny. Okay, that's it for this place. Let's get out of here. Almost done. Oh. Whoa. Ah! Eat it. All right, where was I? Ah! Damn it, where the hell? Jeez. Sneaky little bastards. Okay, let's head to the back. The Adventures of Captain Cosmos, co-starring Jangles, the Moon Monkey. We're gonna see a lot of those guys around. The Jangles character. Okay, and that's that. Now right across this bridge is something useful. We're gonna go over here and get it right quick and then go back to town. I'm not gonna stray too far away from town on this, but right over the bridge is this. Take that. Ouch. You know what? We're gonna go over here. Go ahead and do this. Nice little statue. Because I think we've got an old friend waiting for us over here at the Red Rocket. Hey, look what we have here. Hey.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
All right, let's go.
You wanna come with me, pal? Okay then, let's stick together.
Me and you, buddy. All right, let's head back. That's another area that you can explore. It's got items in it, and you can use it as a settlement base. But we're not going to do it right now. I'm going to go back and stick with Sanctuary at the moment. I just want to go and get the dog first and get that over with. All right. I think there's a couple of more. There's one more place. Here he comes. One more place I can explore coming up here. Why are grenades in the mailbox? That's so weird. I believe I checked that one. Now all this junk here in the town, I'm gonna scrap. All these busted up buildings and trees and bathtubs and tires and junk. I'm gonna clean all of that stuff up and scrap it, but I'm not gonna do it on the Let's Play video. I'm not gonna make you guys watch me sit around and scrap tires for 10 hours, so next time we're together here playing this game, most of this junk, if not all of it, is probably going to be gone. There's one more place I want to hit before I call it. There's an underground shelter in one of these backyards, but I can never remember which one it is. Let's see. Where are you? Thought it was one of the houses in the cul-de-sac. Maybe I was wrong. Up there. There it is. The Root Cellar. Okay, lots of cool stuff down here that we can use. Right away. Oops. Didn't actually mean to pick that up.
Lock's really strong.
Yep, can't pick that one yet. Take the gold bar, I'll sell it. I'm not gonna take all that food. I will take the purified water, though. Duct tape, you definitely want that for adhesive. Just like all the other games, Skyrim and the other Fallout games, I never carry around food that much because I always have plenty of purified water or stim packs or whatever to use, so I don't really carry much food. Alright. Alright, let's get out of here. What the hell was that? It sounded like a snake. Okie dokie. Whoops. Didn't mean to turn the pit boy light on. Okay. So I'm sure people have done this already, how to scrap things. I have a couple of mods installed that allows me to scrap a little bit more than the vanilla game allows. Things like the bushes and brush that's on the ground that you normally can't scrap. This mod allows you to scrap it. Another mod I have also allows you to scrap dead things. Like in this game, when you kill somebody, they'll be laying in the street for indefinitely while you're trying to clean the place up, which is a little weird. But this one mod that I have allows you to scrap those guys up and pick them up. But for the most part, I'm going to go through and everything I don't want, like this car, scrap it. And see, that mod allows me to do things like scrap this bush. You know, so you get the scrap wood from doing that. And like these leaves and junk, you get fertilizer from that. And it cleans things up just a little bit more. But even without it, I still clean up most of this crap because it's useless. So this is what I'm going to do from between this video and the next one. I'm just going to clean up Sanctuary a little bit. You can scrap this entire house. Bye-bye. Scrap all of it. Scrap the foundation, the whole stinking thing. See? Again, I think part of that is from my mod that allows you to scrap extra stuff, but you can still scrap an entire house even in the vanilla game because it's just trashed. And stuff like this you can scrap. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to scrap all this stuff. I did level up, so let me go ahead and choose some something here. It's been so long since I played, I'd forgotten where my stat numbers were. So what kind of thing do I need? Let's see. What kind of perk? Pickpocket? I don't pickpocket very much. We'll go with this, Rifleman. Keep your distance long and your kill count high. Attacks with non-automatic rifles do 20% more damage. We'll take it. Alright. Well, I'm going to call it right there. And like I said, between this video and the next, I'm going to do some scrapping around here. I might level up a couple of times, because you get experience every time you do this stuff. And if I do, I'll get you guys caught up on what my level is. But the next main thing we're going to do in the next video is I think I'm going to take dog meat and we're going to go to Concord, or what I like to call Concord. As usual, thanks you guys for watching. If you liked the video, feel free to comment, give it a like, share it with anyone you think might enjoy it as well, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.